والله يدعو إلى دار السلام ويهدي من يشاء إلى صراط مستقيم.
Brothers and sisters, to increase your iman, read the miracle, recite the Quran, recite it every day and do read it loud. The verses of Quran are all Muslims' pride. This miracle was revealed over a long time span, sent from Allah to an angel, then to a man. That man was Muhammad, the best of creation.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, and welcome to a new episode of Correct Your Recitation. I begin by praising Allah the Almighty and sending the best peace and salutation upon His most beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah alladhi hadana li ni'matil Islam wa kafa biha ni'ma wa ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan 'abduhu wa rasuluhu. Dear brothers and sisters, we'd like to welcome our guests here in the studio. Sheikh Ismail, assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Muhammad, Khalid and Smir, thank you all for joining us today. May Allah bless you all and your families. And you two brothers and sisters who are sitting and watching at the convenience of their houses, thank you for joining us. And may Allah accept this humble effort of all of us and teach us what we don't know, and help us to understand His word, and recite it properly, and act upon it the best way that He likes and wills. Ameen. As usual, we'll begin by enjoying the recitation of Sheikh Ismail, inshaAllah Azzajal. Since he recited last time Surah Al-Mutaffifin and Al-Inshiqaq, despite the fact that we are still at verse number 18 in explaining the meaning of Surah Al-Mutaffifin, today inshallah we request Sheikh Ismail to recite kindly Surah Al-Buruj. Then after that we'll resume elaborating on the meaning of the remaining part of Surah Al-Mutaffifin. So hang around and just listen carefully to his recitation. Sheikh Ismail, tafaddal.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. والسماء ذات البروج واليوم الموعود وشاهد ومشهود قتل أصحاب الأخدود النار ذات الوقود إذ هم عليها قعود وهم على ما يفعلون بالمؤمنين شهود وما نقموا منهم إلا أن يؤمنوا بالله العزيز الحميد الذي له ملك السماوات والأرض والله على كل شيء شهيد إن الذين فتنوا المؤمنين والمؤمنات ثم لم يتوبوا فلهم عذاب جهنم ولهم عذاب الحريق إن الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات لهم جنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار ذلك الفوز الكبير إن بطش ربك لشديد إنه هو يبدئ ويعيد وهو الغفور الودود ذو العرش المجيد فعال لما يريد هل أتاك حديث الجنود فرعون وثمود بل الذين كفروا في تكذيب والله من ورائهم محيط بل هو قرآن مجيد في لوح محفوظ.
Thank you so much. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. In Surah Al-Mutaffifin, in verse number 18, Allah Almighty says, كلا إن كتاب الأبرار لفي عليين وما أدراك ما عليون كتاب مرقوم يشهده المقربون. That is verse 18 through verse number 20. In the previous segment, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala confirmed to us the fate of the criminals, the sinners, and the disbelievers by saying, كَلَّا إِنَّ كِتَابَ الْفُجَّارِ لَفِي سِجِّينَ will be in the lowest of the low, beneath the seventh earth. What is the record? The record of their deeds, of their evil deeds. It's so bad to the extent that it will be deposited and preserved beneath the seventh earth. On the contrary, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala assures the believers and the righteous ones, Al-Abrar, the pious servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that the record of their good deeds will be preserved and deposited in عِلِّيِّين. وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا عِلِّيُّونَ And what will make you know about عِلِّيُّون? This is the knowledge of the unseen. So we have not seen the record, nor have we seen عِلِّيِّين nor سِجِّين. These are informations of the unseen that Allah the Almighty is sharing with us via the wahy, which He revealed to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So in addition to informing us about the unseen, he's confirming that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his appointed and last prophet who receives the wahi from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who's telling us about things that we can never comprehend because simply no one of us have ever seen it or is able to comprehend without being informed via the wahi of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So what's عِلِّيِّين وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا عِلِّيُّونَ? It is the highest place of heaven, above the seventh heaven. So while the record of the criminals will be preserved in Sijjin, on the contrary, the record of the pious and the righteous will be preserved in the highest place in heaven. Where? Very near to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. كِتَابٌ مَرْقُومٌ A register inscribed. يَشْهَدُ